Hey, how you doing? I don't know. There's probably a million videos out here doing this, but here's a million and one. Let's restring a extendable ladder, an extension ladder. All you really need is some rope, knife, and maybe some side cutters. I like to use zip ties at the end of it. Try not to use nylon rope, because nylon rope, after it gets in the elements and everything, gets all dry and actually here, it's all like this. It frays and gets all, actually I just pulled that apart. It deteriorates in the weather. So I'm going to be restringing that ladder. Plus the other one doesn't have one at all. So let's start. I guess, the first thing you need, really, is going to be
an extension ladder. Okay. So basically, you want this, the bottom, to be where the feet are.
Let's see if we can do this from out here instead. Okay, we got the feet on the bottom, that's static. And then up top, where you should have the little protection plastic, that's the part that moves. That's called, I think, the flyer. So that is what moves.
So in a nutshell, you're gonna wanna tie the rope to the bottom rung of the movable part, and then you're going to run the rope in between the two all the way up to the pulley, so in between until you get to where the pulley is. You'll string it through the pulley, and I'll show you from there. Basically, after that, you just run the rope on the underside of the ladder, completely, right down to the other end. So, let's start by measuring off. The rope I got here is a little bit thicker than I would like, but it's what I got on hand, and it's good cord. So take your rope, measure it out by going to your bottom rung and give yourself maybe a couple of feet, a foot or two, at least a foot. That gives you time or length to tie. And basically just take it to the pulley and hang on to that and then bring her back. Actually, this rope I got is probably perfect. We'll see. It might be a little short. Okay. So, you don't really need any fancy knots or anything. I kind of like to go over it and then come over. I don't know if you can see what I'm doing here. I'm basically crossing over, coming back down. And that leaves me kind of like two bits of rope on the bottom rung and a mud dauber right by me. Get away, you son of a bitch! Give yourself enough rope to do what you gotta do. Keep it around center. And the knots don't have to be fancy, they just gotta hold. You're not, this isn't really a weight bearing kind of issue here. So, that's the end here. I like to use a couple of zip ties. Couple of knots, couple of zip ties. Now you don't really want a big bulky knot,
because this is all going to have to travel in between the blades here. That's why I kind of like to do that little loop, and it brings you kind of near the middle of the step anyway. Let's see what we got here. There are a million ways, I guess, to do this. This is my way. There we go. So, remember, go in between. Let me see if I can do this. In between the two, all the way up to the pulley. I'll meet you over there. Hi there. Welcome to my pulley. Gonna pulley access through. Now if I pull a ladder, ooh yeah, it moves. Now the pulley is on your static end. Your pulley doesn't move, except for when it pulls. So run it through. I can say this rope's a little bit thicker than I'd like. But with a little friendly persuasion. I guess the key is, I guess, for the rope, as long as the rope isn't overtaking the pulley, like this is still within the pulley. If that's what's in the view here, where's the pulley? Yeah, see, it's still within the pulley. Now the rest of this basically goes under, like free falling type thing, and under, and all the way back down to the bottom. I'll meet you down there. Hey, welcome to the bottom of my ladder. Where am I? Here I am. Now some people will just leave this all willy-nilly dangling. Bah, that's bullshit. Now, on the static one, go maybe two rungs up and basically give it some slack. Make sure that your ladder is all the way down to the bottom where it's going to sit. You've got some slack there. Now I'm just going to use twist ties for this because this isn't really holding anything at all. You're not pulling ladders. All this is doing is keeping the rope from swinging in the breeze. So yeah, I'll just put a couple of zip ties here. I think I called them twist ties before. That's YouTube for you. Get your brain farts going on. Okay. Got some slack. We're at the bottom of the rung. Zip. I'll do three on this as well. Now at this point, your ladder is good to go. Good to go up, that is. Oh yeah, I know. Now once you get all this together, I guess the most important thing is make sure that this knot, am I in the screen, I can't tell, yep, your knot on your main flyer is going to travel. Like there's, whoa, actually not as much room as I thought in between here, so yeah, let's see if that's going to work. Well, one way to find out, get everything centered up, and let's pull that ladder.
we're good. So, there you go. Not that hard.
I've got nothing bulky to pass through. Actually, it doesn't really pass through all this because it's on its own as it moves. As long as the knots, like, I guess, hanging down here. I don't even know if I'm in screen. You're good to go. You got some slack. Ciao for now.